to get an update on the weather. And Annalise, this would probably be a Canon Aquanet kind of day, or at least a ball cap kind of day, right?
Yes, it would. Absolutely. If you can do the ball cap, that's my advice. Don't even worry with the hair today because we are talking about a lot of wind. As we talked about earlier, there's a wind advisory going in effect at noon. Right now, we already do have quite a bit of wind. As we take a look over Arlington, sustained winds out of the south are at 17 miles per hour. Now, one thing that's really done overnight is keep our temperatures up. It's not as cool as it was this time yesterday. So we're starting off at 66 degrees, extremely mild. Not just that, but the dew point now is at 60. So we've seen our humidity just kind of cranking up in the overnight hours, and that'll continue into today as well. As we take you through the clock, we expect a lot of heavy cloud cover today. I still think we'll see some peaks of sunshine, but more clouds than not. And then those temperatures get to the low 80s for our highs today. Then overnight tonight, looking at another mild setup as we will keep those clouds on the heavy side. Let's talk about the winds, though, as we're moving on through the next 24 plus hours. This takes us into tomorrow. We're still dealing with some gusty conditions, and we'll continue to monitor those winds, especially early on tomorrow. They could be still up to about 30 miles per hour. But today, up to 35 miles per hour, not out of the question, as we'll continue to watch some mega wind, and it's all in advance of this next storm system. So we're watching the storm off to the northwest, closer to the Four Corners. That's going to continue to drift actually through the Central Plains, passing us just to the north as we get into Wednesday. And out ahead of it, we've had that big surge in our moisture content. You can see dew points today in the 60s. That's low to mid 60s. So you really notice how humid it feels. But then the front will start to move in during the early part of tomorrow, and that'll start to dry out our air a bit late day on Wednesday. As far as rain chances go, this is not going to be a soaking rain. We're going to be watching still our eastern fringe, so that hasn't really changed. I'd say late tomorrow morning through the early afternoon hours, needing to watch counties that are east of I-35, and it looks like that would be even east of the Metroplex. But we'll keep an eye on isolated storms for tomorrow. Another potential for rain on Friday, up to a 40% chance. And then the weekend, still talking about some warm numbers as temperatures are pretty much above average in this extended forecast.